keep up with their schoolwork while not falling too far behind on their Netflix watching. But what is this miraculous skill? Well, to most, if you were to ask, they would say multitasking is the performance of multiple tasks at the same time by a single person. Now, this definition holds very little truth. A better definition would be the concurrent performance of several jobs at once by a computer. The reason for this? Simple. Definition one is a lie. I hate to break it to all of you who think you're great multitaskers, but you're not even multitaskers at all. In reality, all you do when multitasking is switch from one activity to the other with extreme speed. And trust me, that's not very efficient. And my friend Joe on the slide behind me is no exception to this either, as you will see. Now, in this scenario, Joe has procrastinated. He has a 5-page essay due tomorrow on US history. But at the same time, like most high schoolers, he really feels the need to finish the remaining 10 episodes he has left at the office. So, like any smart high schooler, he chooses to balance these out by multitasking. Now, at first, this goes pretty well, as seen by the arrows, showing his brain transitioning from one activity to the other. But eventually, if you give it some time, it'll turn into something like this. A jungle of connections, of confusion. His brain just can't seem to transition from thinking about the Great Depression to watching Steve Carell make his best Chris Rock impression. And it's not his fault, it's his brain's fault. This is because part of Joe's brain, called the striatum, ends up being forced to burn more oxygenated glucose than normal, essentially brain food, causing him to lose focus and be tired. Think of it like our bodies in dehydration. When we do a lot of rigorous exercise, our body burns through more water than normal, and eventually we start to feel headaches and feel drowsy. Now, the only way to recover from this is to replenish ourselves with more water, but in the case of the brain, it's with rest. Yet, this is only the beginning of multitasking's downward spiral, as you will see from this flowchart of one of Joe's favorite childhood TV shows. Now, in week one of SpongeBob multitasking, you'll see that his sleep gets slightly affected. Now, this will be because his body will call for the creation of the stress hormone cortisol, raising his stress levels. I know, pretty ironic considering that most people say they multitask to lower stress, when in reality, all they're doing is raising it. But if you give it a few weeks, true changes will occur to SpongeBob's brain. An excellent study at Duke University has shown that people who multitask over the course of 3 months by using social media while doing homework have smaller gray density matter in a part of the brain called the anterior cingulate cortex, which is responsible for cognitive functions such as emotional responses and making tough decisions. So next time you consider multitasking, remember, you're not only raising your stress levels, but you're affecting your body's ability to make tough decisions and respond to the stress you impose on yourself by multitasking in the first place. Now, it's funny I mentioned stress, because most high schoolers say that they multitask to lower stress when studying, as over a third say that while studying, they watch TV. Now, if only this was the truth. The problem is that when you study while multitasking, you don't learn anything. Now, this is because the information you learn ends up bypassing a part of the brain called the hippocampus, which will remember the facts you learn, and ends up in the striatum, responsible for simple processes like writing the letter A. So the next day, when you take that test, you can feel yourself writing the answer, but it won't come out in correct English because it's lost in the wrong part of the brain. But I want to take a step back for a second because being an egotistical, arrogant freshman, I comment a lot about myself. But what about the adults in the room? How are they affected? Well, it turns out they're affected in a pretty similar way as us, except it shows up in the real world with real jobs. It's not Maumee Valley's little bubble anymore. Studies show that adults waste up to 45 minutes a day in the workplace multitasking. But We can't put all the blame on ourselves, as our society demands us to multitask. We're expected to respond to a text message right away when we receive it, training our brain to be hypersensitive to any notification we might receive on our phone. So when you get that text message, you can't help yourself but just to swipe up and respond. And this is a problem, because studies have shown that when we're distracted by, say, an unread email, our working brain IQ drops by over 10 points. And the worst part of all of this is that this phenomenon ends up being addictive. Now, the reason for this is actually quite simple. Your brain interprets you distracting yourself as, say, a mini goal. And so all it wants to do is complete it. So when you distract yourself by checking your Snapchat, your brain feels like it's actually achieved something, causing it to release the feel-good hormone dopamine. Eventually, your brain retrains itself to constantly search for that dopamine release, and so you'll constantly want to distract yourself, no matter how hard you try to stay focused. So, what can we do about all of this? Well, for starters, when you enter, say, writing an essay, you have to put yourself in the right mindset. Tell yourself, I am not going to be distracted. I am going to stay concentrated. No one is going to stop me from getting work done. And the other flip side of this is eliminate the distractions around you. Find a quiet place where no one can bother you and eliminate the phone, either by turning it on Do Not Disturb, or for the mentally weak like me who can't help themselves anyway, hide your phone or have your parents hide it for you. Just keep the phone away from you at all costs. And finally, between doing work, take breaks, relax your brain. I promise you, intense moments of concentration with breaks will equal out to the same amount of work getting done when multitasking. The only difference being that your brain and stress levels won't change. So with that, I want to leave you with a quote from one of my favorite sports coaches of all time, Vince Lombardi. The quote says, "Success demands singleness of purpose." So remember, when you want to achieve something, whether as small as finishing your homework correctly, or as big as starting a business, put your mind to it. Eliminate all distractions around you. And maybe, just maybe, that startup you want to create will succeed.